Hello everyone, let's talk about some of the main features of Java. Okay, so we know that when you have a Java program, you can compile them and you can run them. So what will happen when you compile and you run? When you compile a program, Java C compiler will take place and which will convert .java file into a bytecode file, which is a .class file. Okay, so the Java file, it can be available in your machine, okay, and you can run the class file and you can see the output. So if you want to share the same to the other machine, you don't need to share the Java file, you just need to share the .class file. So .class file, which contains the bytecode, our 0 and 1s, the machine code, okay. So you need to share the class file so they can execute the code in their machine. And they don't need all the software needs to be installed. They just need the JRE needs to be installed. That is what we discussed in the previous slide. Right? So, this is straightforward. In this particular slide and the next slide, we all talk about what we covered so far and what are the concepts we already know. Okay, so JVM executes the bytecode. Of course, JVM executes the bytecode. And the bytecode generated by the compiler with the help of Java C. Right? And that bytecode, right, it can run in any platforms like Windows, Linux and Mac. Correct? See, the ultimate goal for Java, write once and run everywhere or anywhere. You can write in Windows, you can execute in Linux and Mac. You can write in Linux, you can execute in Windows and Mac, or even you can do it in Android operating system also. Right? So the last point, that's what I mentioned, write once and run everywhere. Create and compile, then you can run anywhere. Even if you want me to specifically tell me where, all kind of platforms, all kind of operating systems, including mobile devices. Okay, so there is another important thing which people going for Java. Okay, so whenever we talked about Java, the first major concept comes into our mind is object-oriented language. Okay, so Java is a one of the high visible object-oriented programming language. Right, so what do you mean by object-oriented? Right, so object-oriented means it's a way of organizing your objects. So this is a way where you can organize programs as a collection into a perfect model. For example, let's take an example of animals. Correct? Animals is a collection which contains a different kind of animals. Even though, take a human example. Take a human example, we have multiple collections. Male, female, and transgender. Right? So, for example, under the men, we can have multiple persons with different names. Correct? So, the object-oriented means it's a way of organizing your objects. Correct? So animal is an object. And human is an object. So everything has its own attributes. And another important thing, when we talk about object-oriented language, it is pretty much across all the languages. These four concepts will be available. The first one is abstraction. And the second one is encapsulation. And inheritance and polymorphism, and we can include two more also, the class and the object, that is only specifically belongs to our Java. Okay, so these are the common OOPS concept in across all the languages. Right, so we're gonna talk a lot about the object-oriented programming language and each and every concept separately, like abstraction, encapsulation, inheritance, and polymorphism. Okay, so let's meet each other in the next video. Thank you.